Hey everyone, this is Nick, and today we're going to take a look at how I customized my KDE desktop. The widgets, the panels, the themes, the icons, the colors, the window decorations, virtually anything. It's not too crazy probably compared to a lot of other users' setups, but it's mine and I'm proud of it. Just like I'm proud of this segue to today's sponsor, Linode. So Linode is a fantastic way to get your own Linux server up and running. It was rated the easiest cloud provider to use on G2, and it has been voted top infrastructure as a service provider by G2 and TrustRadius. Linode offers a ton of one-click deployable servers, like Owncast, for example, which lets you run your own Twitch-like streaming service complete with video broadcast and chat, or Apache Guacamole. What's that, you ask? Well, Guacamole is a fantastic way to get your own Linux desktop in the cloud that you can access from anywhere you want. And basically, you can host that on Linode and get to any other computer and get access to that Linux desktop. It's pretty amazing. If you're more into gaming, you can also deploy your own Valheim or Minecraft server in one click. Linode has a ton of these one-click deployable apps. I use Linode to run my own Nextcloud server, which I use to run this whole channel, so I can't recommend them enough, especially since you can now create your account easily using Google or GitHub. And in the future, if you don't have a credit card, you'll be able to sign up using Google Pay as well, so that's one less barrier to get started. So if you want to get a free $100 credit to start your own Linux server, well, head over to the link in the description below and click it. So let's begin with the theme. In previous videos, you might have seen me use another theme called Edna, but the greenish tint just didn't work that well for me, so I moved to a theme called Lion. I have no idea how you're supposed to pronounce that. It's a Kvantum theme, which means that, of course, you will have to install Kvantum. If you don't know what it is, it's basically a theme engine that appears in your Plasma appearance settings. It has its own settings manager that lets you install and change themes. So Kvantum should be in most distros repos. Arch or Arch-based, Solus, Tumbleweed, Fedora, Gentoo, they all have it. On Ubuntu or Ubuntu-based distros, you'll need to add a PPA. I left a link to the installation instructions page in the description. Once Kvantum is installed, all you need to do is download the Lion theme. It's available from kdelook.org. I left a link in the description as well. So basically, from now on, you can assume that virtually everything I mention has a link in the description, unless it's gotten directly from the Get New Stuff buttons from KDE. So once you've downloaded Kvantum, you can just open its settings manager from your menu and click Select Kvantum Theme Folder, and navigate to the folder where you've extracted the Lion theme. Click Install this theme, and then use this theme in the Change Delete Theme segment of the Settings Manager. If you go back to Plasma Settings in the Appearance / Application Style, you can now select Kvantum Dark, and your apps should now start looking like mine. Some will need to be closed and restarted for the change to work. Now, the advantage Lion has is that it has a GDK variant as well, so your GDK apps can look almost like your Qt apps. To install it, just click the Configure GNOME GDK Application Styles in the Application Style panel of the Plasma settings, and then Get New GNOME GDK Application Styles. Search for Lion, and then click Install. Once you're done, close the pop-up window and select Lion Dark in the GDK theme list, then hit Apply. And you're done for the theme. Well, for the applications at least, because Plasma has a lot of places that you can theme. For the icons, I use the inverse blue dark icons, which you can get from the Get New Icons button in the Icons panel. Search for inverse and click Install, then Use. The Plasma theme is also the Lion theme that you can get from the Get New Plasma Styles button in the Plasma Style panel of the settings. And finally, we need the window decorations. The ones I use are called, you guessed it, Lion. You can get them from the Get New Window Decorations, and they're called Lion Aurorae theme. You will get a solid variant that doesn't have translucency and a Lion variant that does. I use the latter, even though not all apps have transparent backgrounds. Now, before we move on to the dock and to the layout, we need to add a few widgets. Right-click on the desktop and select Add Widget. Then click on Get New Widgets and download new Plasma widgets. The ones I used are called Window Title Applet, Latte Separator, Better Inline Clock, and Latte Spacer. Search for these and click the Install button for each one. Once we have all of them, we're ready to move on to setting up the layout. Now, my layout is pretty basic, pretty much macOS inspired. Hey, don't hate me, my previous workplaces have given me Macs for the past 5 years before I moved on to using my own Linux laptop, and old habits die hard. So I have a top panel with a global menu and a dock to run and manage running apps. I don't use the regular Plasma panels to get that result though. I use Latte Dock. It's a fantastic little program that basically pushes the customization options of the Plasma desktop even further. It lets you do a bunch of stuff Plasma doesn't. Like, for example, here you can have a small gap between the panels and the edge of the screen to make them float, or you could use rounded corners, for example. Now, to get access to these though, you'll need the latest release of Latte Dock, version 0.10. You will find a link to the installation instructions in the description. Once Latte Dock is installed, it should be in your menu, so run it. Now, it might display on top of your existing panels, and I would advise you to not immediately delete these panels, even if they're a bit in the way, because if you end up not liking Latte Dock or the layout and you want to get back to your panels, you won't be able to just restore your previous configuration. So make sure you like Latte Dock and the layout before you delete your existing Plasma panels. So Latte can import layouts, and if you want to get my layout in just one click, just head to the description and download it. Then right-click on the dock and select Edit Dock. Then right-click on it again and select Layouts, Edit Layouts. Here you have an Import button. Select Import from Local File and go select the layout you downloaded. Now hopefully this should get you the exact same layout than the one I used. Hopefully. If you would prefer to see each tweak I made, here we go. The main dock, I haven't changed much. I just added the various shortcuts for the apps I used. I removed every applet there that wasn't Latte Tasks and every separator. In the appearance settings, I set an absolute size of 48. I disabled zoom on hover. I added a 10% margin with 15% thickness, and I added 8 pixels between the dock and the screen edge. The background is 50% opaque with a 34% radius and a 29 pixel shadow. I also enabled blur and shadows. In the Effects and Tasks tab, I don't think I changed anything, but here are the contents anyway if you want to pause and replicate these. And now for the top panel. So first right-click on the dock and select Edit Dock. Then right-click again and select Add Dock Panel, then Empty Panel. In that panel, I added the following widgets. The Application Launcher. It's basically the default KDE menu. I configured the applet by changing its icon. I use the draw-circle icon that's available from the All Icons drop-down menu. Then I added the Window Title widget. I configured it to only display the application name, written in bold, and to not show the icon of the app. Then there's a Latte separator and the global menu. I then added a Latte spacer, followed by the Better Inline Clock widget. I configured this one to have a font size of 16 pixel and show the date and separator using a 24-hour clock. Finally, there's another Latte spacer and the system tray widget from the base Plasma desktop. Now, having both Latte spacers use the settings Fill Available Space makes the clock centered in the middle of the panel. In terms of how the panel is laid out, I set it to appear on the top edge, and I checked the Hide Floating Gap from Maximized Windows box. This means that the panel will not leave a gap between it and the top edge when the window is maximized. It just looks nicer this way. In the Appearance tab, I set it to be 28 pixels with a max length of 98%, so it doesn't extend to the full length of the display. I added an 8 pixel gap from the screen edge and no margins at all on the panel. It's 50% opaque with blur and shadows enabled, and it has the same 34% radius and 29 pixel shadow as the dock itself. I didn't change the Effects tab, but here they are just in case. And that's it for the layout. Hopefully, if you just want to copy it as is, you can just download my layout from the description and it will set it up automatically. If it doesn't, you'll have to pause the video and look at each of the settings I just demoed. And now let's tweak the final details. So I moved the window controls to the left of the window because that's what I'm used to. And I removed the maximize button because I never use it. I just drag the window against the top panel to maximize. I also added a Kwin script called Sticky Window Snapping that lets me resize both windows at the same time when they're tiled to each screen's edge. You can get it from the Get New Scripts button in the Kwin Scripts panel of the Plasma settings. My task switcher is set to thumbnails and my window position is set to centered. I use the Roboto font everywhere at 10 pixels except on toolbars where it's at 9 pixels. I also just use the default breeze cursors because I really like them. My splash screen is the Bonnie splash theme that I got from the Get New Splash Screens button, and the login screen theme is also the Layon theme that I got from the Get New SDDM Themes button in the SDDM settings panel. Finally, I disabled the bouncing icon when you open applications because it's stuttery and it doesn't look right to me. You can find that option in the Launch Feedback panel in the settings. And this should basically cover it all. If you want to see how I use that layout, I have dedicated videos on how I use KDE at work. And if you like the layout, don't hesitate to modify it, improve on it, and maybe share your own layouts, maybe on Twitter with me, for example. As with all videos on the channel, this one was made possible by Slimbook, and you probably already know about them by now, but if you don't, they make Linux, laptops, and desktops. They're based in Valencia, Spain, they ship worldwide, they have all price points, all power levels, all keyboard layouts that you might want. I only use their stuff nowadays, so if you need a new device that comes pre-installed with Linux, check out the link in the description below. So thank you guys for watching the video, I hope you enjoyed, if you did, don't hesitate to like and subscribe, or dislike and tell me why in the comments if you didn't like the video. If you want to watch somewhere else than on YouTube, all my videos are also synced on Odyssey, and if you want to help support the channel, you can join my Patreon subscribers and my YouTube members, and you'll get access to a weekly Patreon cast where I discuss Linux, open source, and how I run the channel, and you'll also get the right to vote on the next topics I'll cover. So thank you guys for watching, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye!